Namaste everyone. I welcome each one of you after a very long period of time to this classroom. And in today's class, we are going to be talking about organizing. And following to the previous sessions, we are having next topic, organization structure. That is what we are going to discuss in brief in this session. Now let's get started with the class. Organization structure. How this organization structure has come, this is the outcome of the organizing process. So the organization structure have come from the organizing process only. About the organization process, we have discussed in the previous sessions. Okay, what this organization structure is exactly doing in the organization? This organization structure is very important in the organization to have a better control over the organization activities. So if we wanted to have a good business control, business activities control in the organization, we need to have the organization structure. And apart from this, good flow of communication will take place in the organization because of the organization structure. So the organization structure we can define as, organization structure is a framework within which managerial and operating tasks are performed to achieve the desired objectives. So I am telling, this is my organizational structure. So this is the framework. So the framework is ready. So within this framework, all the activities of the organization should take place. So which are all the activities of the organization should take place within the framework? That is managerial activities and operating tasks. Okay, or operating activities. So the managerial activities and the operating activities should take place within the framework. So the managerial activities could be related to administration side, all the administration activities, and operating activities may be in the production side, purchase, sales, everything, right? So all these activities should take place within the framework. Why it should take place within the framework? In order to achieve the organizational goal or objectives. So if we are not working out within the framework, we cannot attain the organizational goal. So that is the reason why all the organizations should have the organizational structure. What structure means actually? Structure means nothing but different parts or components will be interconnected together. That is called structure, right? In the case of building, example, building we can take. So simply we cannot construct building. Lot of components and parts to be interconnected in order to have a very good building, right? So organization structure also will be framed like that only. So that is the reason why we call it as organization structure is the outcome of the organizing process. Alright, so this is what about the organization structure. So this organization structure will be categorized in various types, right? So types of organization structure we have got many. But commonly, people will be using in the organization, mainly two types of structures will be used, that is divisional structure and functional structure. So in this session, we are going to be talking about these types of structure. Firstly, we will be discussing functional structure. Alright, these are all the commonly used types of structures in the organization. Right? First one is functional structure and the second one is divisional structure. In this session, we will be talking about functional structure first. Okay? What do you mean by functional structure? Functional structure means nothing but grouping of activities will be done in the organization based on the functions which are going to take place in the organization. Why this functional structure to be done and why grouping of activities to be done in order to attain the organizational goal? See, for an example, in an organization, in that particular organization is focusing on manufacturing. If it is a manufacturing company, lot of functions will be taking place like production, marketing, human resource, lot of divisions will be there, right? So, in that, further subdivisions will be created. So, first example in the case of marketing. So marketing department will have many subdivisions, right? So that is grouping of activities. So marketing department will be a group, under that subdivision will be created, right? So based on the functions only, all these functional structure will be created. So subdivision under the marketing department, subdivision would be like sales will be the marketing department will be focusing on sales and promotional activities, and marketing research will be done in the marketing department. So subdivisions will be working separately. So all these things will be done for the attainment of the organizational goal. Now let's see the advantages and disadvantages of the functional structure. Let's see the pros of functional structure. The first pros that we have is specialization. In a department, a group of employees, when they perform the same specific task in an organization, they will get specialized in the particular area, which will lead into get specialization in their job, and ultimately occupational specialization will create, and manpower also could be utilized in a better way, and which will lead into better performance. And the next pros that we have is better coordination and control. When the department people are engaged in doing the same sort of activities in the department, they will have better coordination among the department, and control also will be very good. And the next process, increased efficiency. So because of this functional structure, increased efficiency we could see among the management and among managerial activity, in the managerial activity and the operational activities. So managerial activities and the operational activity will be done very efficiently, and of course it will lead into higher profits of the organization. So the profitability of the organization will be very good. And the next process, minimum duplication of efforts. So minimum duplication of efforts means each and every department, they know each and every function will be done repeatedly by the same group of people. So duplication of the work will not be there, so which will ultimately lower down the economy. The cost factor will be very less in the organization. The resources will not get wasted. So financial resources also will not get wasted because of this function. And next is easier employee learning. Specific activity has been done in the department, so learning also will be taking place very easily. So the employees will be getting very good opportunity to learn in an organization. And next process, importance to all functions. Since the functional structure is giving importance to all the functions in the organization, because each and every function will be functioning independently. So importance to all the functions will be given by the functional structure. These are all the pros of the functional structure. Now let's see the cons of the functional structure. The first con that we have is less emphasis on organizational objectives, which means due to this functional structure, each and every department will be focusing only their department objective. So they will be leaving the organizational objectives. So they will not be emphasizing the organizational objective, rather they will be concentrating only with their department, that is functional objective. So that is one of the con. And the next con is inter-departmental coordination problems. So each and every department will be functioning on as group. So department to department there will be some misunderstanding at times, like the production department will get misunderstanding with the marketing department. So coordination will be lacking. So we cannot expect all the departments will work all the times in a harmonious way, right? So that is one of the cons. And next is interdepartmental conflicts. Of course, as I mentioned now, marketing department and the production department may conflict at times. So interdepartmental, so more than two departments, three departments, when they function, there will be higher level of chances to get conflict. They may quarrel among themselves for different reasons. And the last one that we have is inflexibility. So inflexibility will be possessed in an organization department wise. So each and every department will say ours is very good department. So at last everybody will be responsible only for their department activities and all other things. So nobody will be responsible for the end result of the organization, right? So they will be focusing only their department, their functional area. Okay, so inflexibility will be possessed in an organization. Then the person who is going to take up the position of CEO, chief executive officer, should possess very good general managerial skills. Otherwise he cannot manage all the functional lines of the organization. So these are all the pros and cons of the functional structure. Having understood about the organization structure and the types of organization structure, functional structure, we will end up the session today. I'll meet you in the next class with a new session. Till then, it's bye from Udayana.